And so let's start off with an introduction to of yourselves, your company, and your product.
Okay. My name is John Jimenez. I'm a senior manager for web services for Citrix. Our product that we're demoing here at Google I.O. was a Citrix TV website, which is kind of an enterprise version of YouTube for Citrix and its partners and its employees.
And I'm Albert Lipte, principal web developer, and I did a lot of the plumbing on the back end and on the DMT side.
Okay, so you're using the Google Web Toolkit. What were some of the reasons for you to choose that platform?
We chose Google Web Toolkit for a couple of different reasons. We'd been evaluating the technology for a little while. It was sort of in the back of our minds as we were sort of evaluating new projects as they were coming along. But like the keynote from yesterday, the guy who was demoing the, actually from this morning, the Wave project, he said, you know, very publicly, he wouldn't have been able to do the project without GWT. Feel the same way. We had started sort of evaluating it, thought it was a neat thing, and sort of put it on the shelf until Citrix had to do a resizing, you know, and we lost a lot of the skill set that we would have needed to do the project. So it allowed us to take a lot of guys who are really talented Java developers and allowed them to become really talented JavaScript and Ajax developers. So without GWT, I don't think this project would have gotten off the ground.
Any major technical challenges or cool war stories using the product?
No, we sat down at the beginning of the offset of the project and said, are we committed? And I think we both agreed that we wanted to go the distance. So we basically surmounted all the hurdles we had.
It was a different sort of mindset going into to the developing a GWT application. And I think once we got our mind around how GWT worked, I think everything worked well after that. And coming from a Web 1.0 and a JavaScript development paradigm into the GWT paradigm, once we got our minds right, I think it was all easy. But getting there, it took a little bit.
And one thing to mention too is that, you know, everyone here at the conference is asking for new features, but reality is it really works, and it works well.
So speaking of features, what are some of your favorite features of Web Toolkit?
So I ended up rolling up my sleeves and took off my manager hat and put on my developer hat, and I became a UI developer. You know, like I said, we went through a sort of a reorg, and we lost our two most talented sort of UI and JavaScript developers. So I ended up building widgets and doing all those things. And for me, you know, the hosted mode, being able to do the debugging the application in my Eclipse debugger, that was amazing. I never, you know, in my career as a developer, I've always hated the JavaScript tools. I've always hated that, you know, I never liked Venkman. I've never liked some of the JavaScript debuggers. So being able to debug an application in my native debugger, you know, which is my Eclipse debugger, I think that by itself was worth, you know, whatever pains we had to go through to sort of embrace it.
What about you, Albert?
And for me, I would say that, you know, we have Spring MVC in the back end, and using the RPC out of the box was very, very pleasant and straightforward.
Right. So, an extension of the feature topic, what are some features you'd like to see in GWT?
New features for GWT. Well, we're pretty excited about the features that were announced here, the code splitting. We've already sort of moved to 1.6, but you know, we've been hearing a little bit of buzz about what's going to happen in 2.0. The ability to run your hosted mode in any browser, not just the hosted browser, I think that'll be big, especially for guys who are pushing pixels, right? So the guys that are doing the MVC stuff and the RPC stuff, I think they're not as affected by, you know, opening up the hosted mode browser and waiting, and then compiling it and then bringing up you know, your Firebug and all of that. If you could just do that directly in Firebug right away, I think that would be huge. That would save me a quarter of my day.
And I would have to say better Maven support. I don't think Google quite embraces Maven to the level that we would hope. Secondly, on, I don't know.
I do have one suggestion or something that sort of is always in the back of my mind when I'm working with GWT, is How am I doing? Sorry. So a suggestion for the GWT team is that I feel that the way that J2E sort of didn't get take off until there was some structure around web development, I really feel that the catalyst for J2EE to take off was like Struts or WebWorks or these frameworks that really sprung up because it was sort of the wild, wild west out there. I feel that that's sort of analogous to what's going on right now with GWT. If there was a sort of a more structured way of implementing your applications, I think that would sort of funnel people down the same path, and I think it would be more more traction, and I think it'd be embraced, you know.
So, do you have any advice for people just getting started with GWT?
Some advice for some folks starting out. For us, we went from the Web 1.0 model, right, where we had our wireframes, we had our high-fidelity mockups, and then we had some guys coding HTML pages. When we started with GWT, it was such a different mindset for us that we just started coding Java right away. And figuring out what the right widgets were and figuring out the hierarchy of widgets and the call models and all of that, I think that was sort of painful for us. So I think we would want to, if we started over today, I think we would start back to the low-fidelity prototypes, the high-fidelity prototypes, and then actually creating HTML, looking at the HTML, and then abstracting out what really should be a widget. Instead of coding in Java and seeing how it renders into HTML, sort of going back to sort of the previous model, and sort of finding a commonplace, right?
Yeah, and I think that's one thing Google is, it's not really easy to know what libraries, extension libraries are out there for widgets. Like if you need a special table, like you have to search and you're like, well, does anyone else use this table? And it's sort of, same thing goes with dependency injection. It turns out a lot of people are using gin, but just scrolling the web, it's not that self-evident.
Hey, John, Albert, I want to thank you for your time and sharing with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.